No, I can.
Hello, everyone. Hi, Archana. Love you.
Happy birthday! I haven't missed you yet. Happy birthday, Sandy. I love you so dearly. May you always be this inspirational. Happy birthday to you. Okay, so
I have to say though that I heard all the lovely things you said about me, but there becomes a time when the people. So the last like 20 years that we've known each other, I have learned so much from you. And I think all your fans and well-wishers will second that. So I have to say this out completely, the positions.
You always say that, but actually I want to start from the very beginning. I think when we're growing up, a lot of things that happen to us make us and shape us into who we are. You're someone who I've seen juggling so many things and making it look like effortless. Like, and I think that's what I like to acquire in life, to look graceful even if there's a storm outside. So I just want to ask ki, typically Hindi mein jaise poochte hain, wo bachpan mein aapke saath hua kya ki aap itne superwoman ban gaye? Like you're this Wonder Woman who can do so much and then more.
पहली बात
संध्या, I don't know why I can't hear you. Should I?
Guys, can you hear me? Is my
voice
audible?
No, that's what you meant. First, I thought it's just me, but everyone can't hear you.
What can I do to make it better?
Now I can hear you.
Yeah. Okay. Maybe the mic was getting covered for some reason.
Covered.
All right. So I was saying that it began with me having a feeling like I can never get enough. I can never do enough. I can never know enough. But that comes from a place of sort of need, a place of not feeling adequate. But I think slowly, as you get to know yourself better, it comes from a place of that, you know, I have received so much gratitude. And yes, there have been difficult times. There have been traumas. You know that. You know my whole life story. But I think above all else, you feel like, particularly when you've come out of something, you just feel so much gratitude and you're able to see everything that you have. It's like you can't give back enough. Nothing you can do can ever be enough. That's where I'm at now.
I want to start with what enamored me about you. So there was this moment when we were on the radio and I was somebody who had never participated in elocution or in debates. So I was like so scared that anything would come out of my mouth. Because typically when I speak, I don't think without thinking, I feel more. So Sandhya tells me, you're the queen of the airwaves. Just cool, relax. And I'm thinking, how is she so chilled out? And the next thing I knew, she was, like I said, she was pregnant. She was going swimming. Then she did something I love. I love water. She did deep sea diving. She became, what was that thing called? The certificate you had?
Rescue diver?
Rescue. Yeah. You were the rescue.
That's because I had kids in the water. Somebody had to look out for them.
she can rescue anywhere around the world if she's deep sea diving. She has the license to save. And she would keep doing online courses even before you and I could even think of it. So here's, before I come to your professional side, which is wellness and mindfulness and all of that, Sandhya, how is it possible ki aapne ek life mein itni sari cheeze manage ki, 24 ghante hote hain, aaj 24 tarikh hai, time management sikhaiye.
Okay. First things first, let me go back to our early days of radio. पहले मुझे डर लगती थी कि अर्चना कुछ बोल देगी ऑन एयर पे. देन आई गॉट टू नो यू एंड आई लर्न टू थिंग्स. वन इज दैट नोबडी कैन टेल अर्चना व्हाट टू से और व्हाट नॉट टू से, आई कन्फेस. बट द सेकंड थिंग वाज दैट एवरीथिंग अबाउट यू वाज ब्यूटीफुल, यू नो. सो इट बिकेम, आई मीन टू मी इट वाज टू जस्ट लेट द एसेंस ऑफ यू शाइन ऑन एयर. And I think you've been so authentic. I can vouch for the fact that over 20 years, what you are on air is the person you are in real life.
God
bless you. You're really blessed that you have this job where people can see the essence of you and you touch so many lives. And I'm really honored to know you for that as well. You've touched mine in so many ways. About time management, I will say this. I think I learned this from Warren Buffett, as many people have. I didn't like the sound of it at first, yeah. But that you end up saying no to more things than you say yes to. I think we often have this notion that ye hamara farz hai, hamein ye karna chahiye. Somebody asked me this, I have to do this. How can I say no? It's about knowing where your obligations lie and knowing that we have finite energy and what your priorities are. I have had to say no to so many things. I don't really go out because I it's a choice that you make. Whenever yeah. we make a choice, we are picking one route, but we are closing another route in that sense. Aisa yeah. kabhi bhi nahi hota hai ki, you know, have your cake and eat it too. You can have it yeah. all. Anybody who says that, they're just telling you that, listen, you're paying a price for it, maybe not now, but there will be a price for it for sure later. So the yeah. sooner you understand what routes you're closing for yourself, the clearer your path forward also becomes, and a lot simpler. You know, the fewer decisions you have to take, the rest of it is just noise in the background. It's not your obligation. It's not your to-do.
Choose from the list of things you have to do. But it's also that you have two children. You have two beautiful boys who I think are so gorgeous, so loving, so warm, so kind. And to raise them while you're actually pursuing your career is not easy. It's a huge choice. And we all know the statements some very, very prolific women have made regarding this, that you can't be successful workwoman and be a mother. So I want to know about that part as well. I'm sure that wouldn't have been easy.
For that, I think my biggest learning has been that it is a fallacy. Aisa myth hai ki hamara career ka ek hi graph hona chahiye, ki ye straight line bilkul hona chahiye. You know that I quit once I had baby number two. Oh, was it baby number one? Sorry. You know, after a while, between kids, pets, you start getting confused between all of them. I don't even call any of them by name because I'm not sure.
Okay, so all the people here, Sandhya has a garden of, it's an enviable, it's like a forest in a house, and she has इस कैट को भी गोद ले लेते हैं, इस डॉग को भी गोद ले लेते हैं, इसको भी बुला दो. आई थिंक एंड देयर इज एनी डॉग और कैट टू रेस्क्यू पीपल थिंक ऑफ संध्या एंड दे सेंड देम टू हर हाउस बिफोर दे गेट अडॉप्टेड. सो दिस इज मोर शी मैनेजेस. हां सॉरी, प्लीज गो
ऑन. नो नो, बाय द वे वी हैव अ थ्री लेगेड डॉग जॉइनिंग अस नेक्स्ट वीक, सो आई विल शो यू हिज पिक्चर वेरी वेल. नो, ही इज सो क्यूट. ओके, सो द पॉइंट बीइंग दैट इन ऑल ऑफ दिस यू हैव टू नो when to take a back seat, when career takes a back seat, when family is sort of like a little bit on autopilot, but it's still, it's about having, always knowing what's important to you. And I've made many mistakes in the past. There have been times when I've been obsessed with work, and I know my family has paid a price for it. Now, the way I think of it is that the career can take different paths. You know, it's not meant to be. And even if you don't have a family and plants and, you know, pets, it's still, there's so many things for which we need to take time for. There may be a time when you just need to discover yourself. There may be a time when you need to be there for somebody else, your parents or a friend or a partner, or just, you know, to develop a hobby. We have this feeling ke hamesha zyada hona chahiye. Abhi last year hamara salary itna tha, to agla saal zarur plus 10% plus 20% hona chahiye. Once you get rid of these notions, you can realize that happiness comes really from doing the things that are important to you, and that we need so much less to be happy, as long as we're doing the things that are what make us truly happy. You know,
you keep adding every year. Like, I believe you were doing a course this morning as well, so as we speak you are learning even more, despite the fact that you in many ways are a life coach now. You're helping people with mental health, with physical health. My god, guys, I have to say, I did this Kenzai diet thanks to Sandhya, and it helped me like crazy. So right now, I have to ask, what is it that makes you learn so much more? You're always inquisitive to learn more, to add more.
कुछ लोग ऐसे geek ही होते हैं, तो that side of me definitely does exist. But also, अच्छा, मुझे बहुत डर है कि मेरा brain ऐसा stuck ना हो जाए. I think the minute you feel like abhi mujhe pata hai abhi ye bas ho gaya, then what happens is, you know, we lose the learner's mind. And now neuroscience tells us this, mindfulness tells us this, that we must always have a beginner's mind. We must have curiosity. We must be open to learning new things. Usse hamara life ka quality bhi acha ban jata hai, but our brain quality also, hopefully. But also more importantly, you know, it's that you stay young at heart, you stay young at mind, and just your whole world changes. Every time that I learn something new, it opens a new world for me. So it's wonderful.
A kid challenged you recently with the skipping. You're awesome with the skipping, by the way. Oh my God. Every time I think of Sandhya skipping, I'm feeling like I'm a 90-year-old. So when I see this young kid, I don't know how old was he, 14 or something?
11. He was 11. My God. Yes.
And happy birthday to Sandhya, everybody. It's her birthday. The girl here who is looking gorgeous in her green sari. So I just want to ask you, so you never tire. Don't you have those days where you only forget it? I don't want to work out. I don't want to attend this class. I don't want to do anything.
Pretty much every day, to be honest.
No.
But yes, especially when it comes to workout. I'm not putting my workout out on Instagram. Nobody's giving me shabashi every day. It's not that, you know. But why we do it, and that's the beautiful thing about anything becoming a habit. Aisa almost autopilot ban jata hai ki hame itna sochna nahi padta hai. As if it's like as if you're wearing a uniform. You know, every morning you get up, you brush your teeth, you wear your uniform, and you go. तो ऐसा है कि मुझे उठना है, मुझे एक्सरसाइज करना है, अभी मुझे पाठ पढ़ाई करना है, एंड देन आई गेट ऑन विद माय डे, यू नो. सो यू आर नॉट डूइंग इट फॉर द रिवॉर्ड्स, यू आर नॉट डूइंग इट फॉर द एंड गोल, यू आर डूइंग इट जस्ट बिकॉज द एक्ट इन इटसेल्फ, वन इज ऑटो पायलट, बट ऑल्सो विद समथिंग लाइक स्टडिंग, द एक्ट इन इटसेल्फ इज एंजॉयबल. आई एम नॉट डूइंग इट फॉर द सर्टिफिकेट, आई एम नॉट डूइंग इट टू बीट एनीबॉडी इन एन एग्जाम. ओके, द स्किपिंग चैलेंज आई डेफिनेटली डिड इट टू बीट द किड. आई वाज अ लिटिल अशेम्ड दैट ही वाज 11 एंड आई हैड टू tell his mom I'm gonna kill him, but he's already beaten me. So
I want to tell everyone who is watching that Wazir Siddiqui, aapko Eid Mubarak advance mein kar ke liye main aapko sabko batana chahti hu ki Sandhya apne health ka khyal rakhti hai, apne as you can see beauty ka khyal rakhti hai, lekin wo bahut sare courses, in fact she ran a business because of which humko bahut fayda hua. Ghar ki itni sundar cheeze wo rakhti thi और हम जाके ऐसे ला 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 शॉपिंग करके आते थे. सम ऑफ माय बेस्ट थिंग्स इन माय होम वर फ्रॉम हर स्टोर, एंड आई फील प्रिविलेज्ड टू नो समवन हु हैज डन सो मच इन वन लाइफ टाइम, एंड दैट्स व्हाई शी इज हियर. बट आई थिंक दिस लॉकडाउन हैज डेफिनेटली ब्रॉट सम वेरी पर्टिनेंट इश्यूज, जो कहीं दफनाए गए थे हमारी लाइफ में, वो थोड़े अभी सर्फेस हो रहे हैं क्योंकि हमारे पास और कोई ऑप्शन नहीं है. Try its relationships in the home with people, whether it's the way you look at your home itself, your life itself, interpersonal relationships, even professionally, you know, because you're at a distance, somehow you're managing to see things clearly, or you're getting perspective on them. Up wellness, mindfulness, life coach bhi hai. How do you think ye lockdown, jo shayad kuch logon ke liye who are watching this extend ho sakta hai, how do you think they can use this better, and what are the kind of life lessons you can teach us that probably some of your friends and your students and people you're coaching are taking away from you during this lockdown?
This lockdown has been hard for everybody. You know, that there are very real fears that we've had to face. For a lot of us, we're thinking about mortality for the first time. We're worried about family. We're thinking about separation. We're dealing with all of these issues. But in a way, two things I will say. One is the unifying nature of it. Pehli baar, probably history of mankind mein, the whole world is experiencing something together. So yeah, so that is, I think, a very powerful force. And it's in a way a call to awaken consciousness. You know, hamare shastron mein likha gaya ke, you know, after Kaliyug there will be somebody who will come and awaken our consciousness. So I, for me, that's the way I see it, that this is a call for us to awaken really. The second part of that is that in a sense ye midlife crisis hai hum sab ke liye, because it is a chance for us to, what is a midlife crisis, ek chance hai rukne ke liye, something has made you stop to say, wow, what is happening to my life? What is happening to my life till now? And how do I want the rest of my life to look? So I would say, whether it's a midlife crisis, whether it's lockdown, this is a fabulous chance for us to have that look. And nobody needs to teach you anything. जब हम लोग अपने अंदर देखते हैं तो हम लोग पहचानते हैं, for the first time, you know, we understand what's going on within our body, we understand what's going on within our emotions, we understand what's going on just with our deepest of desires. And that will tell us what direction we want our life to go in. Aajkal aisa hota hai ki we don't even, like, there was a time when I was ill for 2 months and I didn't even realize it because I was so out of touch with my body. हम लोग पार्लर भी जाते हैं तो कोई और कुछ करता है, ट्रेनर कुछ बोलता है, हम लोग ऐसे ही एक्सरसाइज करते हैं. यू नो, वी आर नॉट रियली लिसनिंग टू आवर ओन सिग्नल्स. नहीं तो वी आर लिसनिंग टू द फोन, वी आर लिसनिंग टू समथिंग, टॉकिंग टू समबडी व्हाइल वी आर डूइंग इट. नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस इज वी आर फोर्स्ड टू एक्चुअली लिसन. कितना, हाउ मच आर वी गोना वॉच टीवी, हाउ मच आर वी गोना एंटरटेन आवरसेल्व्स एंड ज़ूम कॉल्स एंड ऑल ऑफ दैट. सो व्हेन वी आर फोर्स्ड टू लिसन, वी कैन हियर अ लॉट, वी कैन सी अ लॉट, वी कैन फील अ लॉट. And that really is something that we should all embrace. And that will really tell us, we are the nobody knows us better than ourselves. So if we can just listen.
But then some of us will start playing a video game. We'll start doing Netflix and chill. We'll start again probably calling friends and talking about sweet little nothings. A lot of us can get into that mode, you know. And because we feel, maybe we're ignoring the real issues. Because we feel that it's safer. Play a game, play. You know, kuch dekh lo. Many of us, actually reading I find very therapeutic, but a lot of us might be ignoring that even. So how does mindfulness teach you to do that inner viewing, so to say?
Okay. So mindfulness is nothing but the entirety of your presence to something. Jab hum log Netflix dekh rahe hain, we are like mentally switched off. Our brain is just being passively fed with sounds, noise, chips, popcorn, whatever we have access. It's like we are just consuming, you know, without having any awareness. Anything that you do with awareness, even if you are washing bartans, sabzi kaat rahe, if you just bring the entirety of your presence, even if you have to look after children or jhadu pocha, say that, you know, I'm aware now that I'm doing jhadu pocha. Get used to sensations in your body. Oh, my back is hurting a little bit. Oh, I can feel the water running over my hands. You know, It's nothing earth-shattering. The more you learn to come back to yourself, the more you learn to have that awareness of yourself, all the answers will start coming out. You'll recognize your feelings. You'll learn to stop judging them. You'll be much more aware of them. That awareness is the beginning of change. That is more than 50% of change.
You know, I always wanted to ask you this. When a lot of us, bahut logon ko gussa aata hai. और वो गुस्सा हम एक्नॉलेज नहीं करते हैं. कुछ लोग करते हैं, कुछ लोग ओवर एक्सप्रेस कर लेते हैं, कुछ अंडर एक्सप्रेस कर लेते हैं, और कुछ लोग बात ही नहीं करते हैं. तो आई जस्ट वांट टू आस्क यू कि एक्नॉलेजिंग योर फियर्स, योर यू नो, योर एंगर और अदर थिंग्स, एंड हाउ डू यू गेट रिड ऑफ अ लॉट ऑफ द इमोशन दैट रियली डोंट टेक यू एनीवेयर, बिकॉज व्हाट वुड यू गेन इफ यू वर टू इवन एक्सप्रेस एंगर, जस्ट सेइंग.
सो दिस गोज बैक टू नॉन जजमेंट. Our emotions actually are very useful because they tell us a lot about ourselves. Suppose, me, so what is the root of our anger? What is the root of our anger? We want something. Somebody is behaving in a way that we feel is wrong. We wish that they would behave a certain way. So what is it that we want? Maybe we want fairness. Maybe, and from that we'll understand that maybe we were not treated fairly at some point, and we now want that people should. Or we want people to see us, and you know the root of it is almost always universal. हम लोग चाहते हैं कि कोई हमें देखे, हमें पहचान ले, हमें प्यार दे, हमें इज्जत दे, और कि सब लोग एक साथ मिलजुल के रहे, कि हम लोग भी सेफ रहे. These are all pretty universal emotions, and when so use these emotions that come up within you to see what is at the trigger, what is at the root of it. What is jealousy? Jealousy is you saying that I want what she has. I want what he has. Why do I want it? It's because I never got the love, or it's because I feel I can be better. There you go. That's your answer right there. If you feel you can be better, come on then. It's not, don't waste your time being jealous. See what you can do right now to be better. But it's also a fallacy ki mujhe unke level pe hona chahiye. No two people's journey can be the same. Hum sabka starting point alag hota hai. Then our journey also has to be unique. Why should we go on somebody else's path? It's so boring, right? So if we're separating these two things, our emotions are extremely powerful. And then it's not about getting rid of your anger or getting rid of your hatred or jealousy. I will just say it's like how you raise children. You can't tell them, beta, don't do that. Because if you tell them, don't do that, that is exactly what they will do. Instead, you encourage the behavior that you want to see. So that's the same for ourselves. You water the seeds that you want, you know, your drive, your compassion, the things that make you happy, your love, water those. Pay more attention to that. Spend more time in those spaces. Distract yourself from the spaces that you find negative. Once you've identified what the root is, apne aap wo unko weeds bolte hain. Apne aap ye weeds mar jayenge. Pani nahi dalenge to mar hi jayenge na. Yeah, you're just not paying attention. There's no big fight or battle in us.
What is wellness? I mean, mindfulness, I still get what you just told us, but what is the wellness aspect that you have learned and you also are teaching a lot of people, you're coaching people into?
We often think of wellness as the absence of disease. So I use disease actually as the definition. Disease ka matlab kya hai? Dis-ease. Ki hamare andar andar kuch to aisa gadbad jaisa lag raha hai. So really wellness is about putting yourself completely at ease on multiple levels. It's your body, your emotions, your mind, your socialization, who you have around you, because these also impact your sense of ease, your sense of comfort, hamara environment. We can't just do jhadu pocha na house and put all the kachara outside, right? The kachara flies right back in. So awareness of your bigger environment, awareness of your financial status, ye sab jo bhi cheez hame dis-ease de sakta hai, we need to do some housekeeping for all of that. That becomes wellness then. You are not in dis-ease anymore.
You've always taken care of your health, I know, but how has the lockdown in any way aided or made you feel even more physically fit? Or what are you doing to keep even more health-wise, at your best?
You mean besides challenging inappropriately 11-year-old children? And so again, we often look for excuses. Gym nahi hai, gym band hai, to hum log exercise kaise karenge. We have this mentality, all or nothing, you know. But that's when we have to understand that when you recognize what is important to us, ki mujhe bas ye shareer ko maintain karna hai, abhi kaun si Miss Universe mein bhaag lena hai, you know. So that feeling that we don't have to go 100% each and every time, but थोड़ा थोड़ा आज 5% 20% 30% कुछ भी किया, but it's about showing up every day for it. So like just whether it's your housework and couple that with a little bit of meditation, with a little bit of squats, little bit of skipping, it's just showing up regularly to do something. It doesn't have to be perfect, but it doesn't have to be zero either. 5% better than 0%.
You
can be completely mindful when you're doing jhadu pocha, when you bring the entirety of yourself to it. But in terms of exercise, do keep in mind that a lot of these activities, while they're tiring, they're more mentally tiring than physically good for conditioning, you know. The fact is that we have three aspects to physical fitness. There's endurance, there's resistance training. So first cardiovascular, resistance training, and flexibility. Now, if you think about that, you know, a lot of what our tiredness actually is coming from is us doing work that we're not used to or that we don't particularly enjoy. That's why we're feeling tired. But it may not have these three aspects of it, you know, flexibility, resistance training, and cardiovascular. So we need to be able to incorporate these three aspects in somehow. This cardiovascular, simple as doing 100 jumping jacks. Resistance training, use your own body weight. Do a few squats, do a few push-ups, do a few crunches. Flexibility, do a few stretches, yoga stretches, you can do it off a YouTube video, and then just a few minutes of calm after that, sit in quiet contemplation, there you go, they have mind and body covered. Do it with your chai if you must, but that's it.
Wow.
By the way, 80% also is, you know what they say, na, abs are made in the kitchen. 80% diet ke upar hai. To abhi to hum log ghar ka khana, you know, just simple sabzi, dal, roti, chawal, that is actually the food of champions. So again, this is a blessing in disguise ke hume sirf excellent conditioning food mil raha hai, to hume khana chahiye. Aur, you know, this is actually the best physical conditioning for us as well. 80% is your diet.
Wow. And I'm thinking the fact of eating fresh food, because a lot of us, hum log khana cook karke ghar leke jaate, I mean the office leke jaate, and then we eat it like 4-5 hours later. So, you know, you always yearn for how would it be if you had fresh food every day. Aur wo ho raha hai abhi in the lockdown.
Yes, absolutely. Again, we should understand the things that we should be willing to compromise on. For example, you can cook up a big batch of food and immediately put it into the freezer. You don't need to wait for room temperature, 3-4 hours, whatever, put it in the freezer. Take it out, thaw it out, eat it, heat it up and eat it, you know. So these are the kind of compromises we can make. I would say any day home-cooked frozen food will be, and then heated up and eaten, is better than something that comes out of a packet, you know, which has additives to it, which has preservatives to it, which has a lot of artificial ingredients that hyper flavor the food, you know. There's some famous packets of chips and stuff, it's like with the tagline, no one can eat just one, that no but one can
you,
eat just
you
one.
Ever eat any of this, or it's an absolute no for you?
Again, 80% 80-20 rule. If for 80% of the time agar hum log acha poshak khana kha rahe hain, 20% of the time you can get away with whatever badmashi you want. So if you're asking me, do I eat junk? Yes. But yeah. Two things happen. One is that you just need to eat very little, and again, if you're eating it mindfully, you know, just that we love that feeling of crunch, we love the feeling of saltiness. If I'm fully aware that I'm doing it, one small katori is all that I need. And the second thing is, once you start enjoying the taste of just healthy, fresh food, you actually start losing the taste for artificial flavored food. You know, I see that happen. Yeah, yeah. So once you
want it, I don't lose taste for chocolate.
So that is one of our deepest rooted. We are rats. Hum log sab chuhe hain. And rats need sugar. The craving for glucose is our most primeval instinct, my dear. Glucose ke bina hum log mar jayenge. So it is hardwired in our rat bolo, early man bolo, caveman bolo, cave woman, whatever. It is hardwired in us. Aur hum log kya sochte hain? Aaj itna tension ho raha hai. Our caveman brain is telling us, boss, I'm going to die. I need glucose. So we stress with, I need this to survive. You know, we our brain only knows death, threat, you know, threat, death, and I need glucose. So that is such a, once you recognize, again, once you have that awareness that this is my rat brain that's craving the sugar, you know, you can wait for just 10, 15 minutes, 80, 90% of the time, the craving will go away. But once in a while, if you, like I said, if you've been 80% of the time eating healthy, one, just wait for that craving and you'll say, yeah, I'm going to enjoy a piece of chocolate right now, and I'm going to enjoy it. You know, enjoy the sweetness. Why do we love sugar? Because our brain rewards us when we have it, right? We get a dopamine hit. So I'm saying go for it. By all means, get it. But do it mindfully.
You know, before we end this conversation, mujhe aapse ek sort of guru dakshina hi chahiye ki kaise hai ye aapne logon ki life abhi coach karna shuru kiya hai. You're actually helping them achieve their goals. If you could share with all of us, because all of us have goals in life and all of us want to get somewhere. Agar aapki koi, without taking the name, koi student hai jiska example dete hue, aap bata sakte ho ki how have you managed to get him or her towards their life goals, and how can we try and achieve them as well?
It'll be sure. The first thing about a coach is that we don't actually tell people anything. Like I said, the answer lies within you. The more you get to know yourself, so, and you know, we are ourselves when we are most childlike. So think back to who you were as a child. Think back to the activities that you did that you just enjoy doing for the sake of doing. Maine keh rahi hu ki ye aapka career hona chahiye. But bring that into your life, because then you get to know yourself a little better. Aur phir goals ke liye na, the most authentic that you feel. There are a lot of tests that you can do online that tell you, you know, what are the kind of tasks that you enjoy. Are you more procedural? Are you more creative thinking? Are you more spontaneous? Then you try and build like a job around that. And no matter what your job is currently, you can start pivoting towards that also. You have to open your mouth and ask. You know, sometimes we're in an organization, we don't have that much ability ke, CEO banna hai. Or aaj mujhe job ye naukri chhodke advertising join karna hai. It's not about that. It's about speaking. Recognize a role that you would enjoy playing and say, tell your boss, you know, can I try this out? Can you give me a chance to do this? People, every good leader knows that if an employee is engaged, if an employee is working to his or her full strength, that is when you will find your flow. That is the employee who is going to shine in an organization. So a good leader will actually give you that opportunity. Slowly, slowly, as you build, you start working in the direction more of your real strengths rather than ki mummy ne bola finance karo, toh maine finance kiya. If finance is your strength, then by all means. Yes?
There is a pertinent question that's come from our viewer here. Shibi says, but what if I don't even know what I like? What is it that I really enjoy? How do you go to that
element? Two things. One is that you got to try a couple of different things. Hum log bachchon ke saath kaise kya karte hain? We put them for like, beta ye class try karo, wo class try karo. You know, we have to try some things and do it on your free time. Take a course, see if the subject matter is of interest to you. And like I said, do these exercises. There are so many exercises today that you can do to kind of understand who you were. But above all else, I will say spend time with yourself. Look at who you are. You know, your childlike state is who your essential nature is. Look at Archana. She's always childlike. You can tell that she's enjoying herself, you know, doing what she's doing, right? It shows through. You
were an RJ. You became a business, an entrepreneur. You, like I said, been a deep sea diver. And you've been a lot of things. If I had to ask you, I'm a very avid traveler. People, I think that's her biggest education in this world. But if I had to ask you, you kind of, I feel, you discovered your calling with being a coach. Would that be right for me to say? And do you feel this is where you want to be? This is it. This is where you want to grow. And this is how you want to see yourself in life.
Yes. A lot of it, Archana, is that aisa bhi hota hai ki, you know, we have some whims. कि मुझे थिएटर करना था. आई मीन वी समटाइम्स हैव मेनी इंटरेस्ट्स, बट आल्सो व्हाट टेंड्स टू हैपन इज समटाइम्स वी ब्लॉक सर्टेन एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ अस. दैट हैपेंड विद मी. आई काइंड ऑफ इनहेरेंटली फेल्ट दैट आई एम नॉट अ पीपल्स पर्सन एंड दैट आई फेल्ट आई माई सेल्फ वॉज वेरी वॉलेटाइल. बट समवेयर once I came to realize that, and you were one person who always told me this, that Sandhya, you're made for, you know, working with people. You have so much compassion. Sometimes we don't believe that about ourselves, you know.
And I want to tell everyone here, there have been moments in my life, and actually those moments always drive me to her house, but I'm just lost and I feel like I need some perspective, and the only person I can think of at that moment is Sandhya, because she literally lives like on my way home from the studio, and I'm like, Sandy, I'm just coming, and she'll have the best food ready for me, and she'll just stand for me silly, and I'll be like, just tell me, what do I do? And she literally put it like a story from a book, and I would just get my answers. So yeah, it's a big gift you have, Sandhya, big gift.
So, but also it's about knowing yourself, Archana. I've always pushed sort of be your authentic self. I think somebody was asking a question as well. How do we branch out? Very often it doesn't have to be a separate branch. I will say incorporate it into your life in one way or the other, you know. So say something is telling you that I'm artistic, but my job right now is very, kya bolte, left brain. So I will say, yes, bring a little bit of art into your life. Start painting, you know. That will tell you that then tomorrow you can have a very artistic life that involves Excel sheet. So I'm not joking. Once you allow this to come into your life in a small way, you yourself will come up with the most unbelievable of suggestions. You'll say to your boss that, listen, I'm really good with numbers and I have a real passion for art. Allow me to creatively find a solution for this company where we can improve our finances in a way that we've never tackled before. You see what I mean? You're bringing all sides of your personality. We have certain skills, we have certain passions. When we marry skill and passion And if that can also get us money, nothing like it. But you know, sometimes they can be a little separate, but I'm saying give it space in your life and it will become a part of your life at some point. No hurry.
This has been for sure a very 360 degree encapsulating conversation, starting from radio talking skills to everything. But I just want to thank you for being there for people. It's a big line in this today's day and age. Because like Sandhya ne bola ki, सिर्फ उनके परस्यूट्स ने उनको नहीं बनाया, उनके लाइफ में जब उन्होंने अपने बच्चों के लिए ब्रेक लिया, उनकी माँ के लिए ब्रेक लिया, उनके कुछ फैमिली मेंबर्स फ्रेंड्स के लिए ब्रेक लिया, शी फाउंड हरसेल्फ. समटाइम्स बीइंग देयर फॉर अदर्स कैन हेल्प यू फाइंड यू द ट्रू यू, एंड दैट्स अ बिग डील इन टुडेज डे एंड एज. हम लोग भूल जाते हैं कि दूसरे भी हम उनके लाइफ में चेंजेस ला सकते हैं, उनकी लाइफ को एनरिच कर सकते हैं. व्हेन वी स्टार्ट बिलीविंग दैट अबाउट अवरसेल्फ, एवरीबॉडी स्टार्ट लिविंग फॉर ईच अदर एंड इट्स अ ब्यूटीफुल वर्ल्ड. Sounds very idealistic, but it's something you're living and something I feel you have managed to do.
This real strength, we become like an army of compassion. We become a compassionate race, as opposed to rat race. So that's the choice that we have.
Now every time I see a chocolate, I'm gonna see a rat in me.
My job is done. My job is done. Yes.
Anyway, people think I look like a chewy. Thank you so much, Sandhya. And for all the people watching this, please follow her. There are lots of webinars that she's going to be conducting in the coming days. And she'll post the details of the same. So if you want to join her there, that'll be lovely. And thank you, Sandhya, for doing this for us. Seriously. Lovely. And your sari, you rock the bikini and the sari just the same.
same for you. Yes. No, thank you guys. Thank you so much. Be safe. Be well. Do reach out. I have a YouTube channel called Sandhya Krishna. Go ahead, ask a question there. I'm happy to help. And you know, let's make good health. Let's make compassion our strengths. Really.
So well said. Thank you, Sandy, and all the very best for a beautiful day. I hope you get some gift from somewhere. You give so much to the world. You deserve it. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you. This is the best gift. Thank you so much, guys. Bye.